Greetings, everyone. Bryant back with more Ace Combat 7 Skies Unknown. Last episode, took on the first mission, did the tutorial, finally remembered all the controls.
As of 1 p.m. today, the Kingdom of Arugia has declared war on the Ocean Federation. As soon as the news broke out, enemy aircraft began bombing Ocean territory, causing widespread destruction. The Air Defense Force has released a statement saying this violent attack was carried out by drones. They speculate the drones were secretly transported to Osea in shipping containers and launched remotely. The Secretary of the Navy has stated that the enemy was targeting naval ports across the country. According to the Secretary, all of the nation's aircraft carriers, including one still under construction, sustained severe damage in the attacks. We have yet to hear back from the department as to the fate of Osean carriers currently at sea. Hold on. I've just received breaking news. The International Space Elevator, which is being built in southern Yuzha, has been seized by the Arugian Army. Reports say former President Harling was touring the site at the time, but his current whereabouts are unknown.
Ah, shit.
Our sources in government tell us it was Harling's policies regarding the space elevator that caused economic frictions in the area, and which ultimately led to this war. Located near Arugia, on the continent of Yuzha, the space elevator has been under construction for some time now. The Executive Office of the Ocean Federation has declared a national state of emergency. They have ordered all its armed forces, including Yuzhan peacekeepers, to mobilize and make the necessary preparations to launch an immediate counterattack. Ladies and gentlemen, our country is officially at war. Stay tuned for further updates.
Breaking news from ENN. Osea launched an attack on the capital today, striking Farbanti from their aircraft carrier, the Kestrel II. After a brutal battle, the Arugian Air Force successfully repelled them. During the air raid, the Ocean Air Force fired missiles at the city and managed to shoot down a number of Arugian fighters. Some of the disabled planes then crashed into residential areas.
The world was screwed. So for people that have never played... still a cutscene.
Yuzha was on the wrong side of the planet and got hit. Hard. Refugees swarmed the Arugian Republic, the biggest country on the continent, plunging it into chaos. They were desperate and started a war, one they had no hope of winning. That's the war my dad fought and died in. The biggest nations from two continents went head to head, and the so-called righteous Oceans struck the deal that ended it. They fancied themselves the only nation that could bring peace and stability to the world. They even tried saving the Yuzhans, still suffering from the disaster. That's how a space elevator, stretching way up into the sky, ended up being built in Yuzha, paid for by the Oceans. President Harling said he did it out of compassion for his fellow humans. But to the folks in Arugia, it looked like Osea was moving in to take over. Arugia went from being a republic back to being a kingdom. When they started this new war, they managed to get the drop on everyone. The second the declaration hit the news, Arugian forces took control of the space elevator without spilling a single drop of blood. President Harling was touring the elevator when it happened and disappeared. Then, while that was going on, the Arugian ships that were docked all around Osea released a swarm of drone fighters they had hidden on board in containers. No one thought they were capable of doing what they did that day. With pinpoint accuracy, they managed to take out everything that was military, and not a single civilian was hurt in the process. Osea pissed lots of people off with their huge military presence around the world. Arugia didn't have the same reach, but they could hit their targets faster and cleaner. And when all this was going down, I just so happened to be in my flying drag racer. In case you were wondering, yeah, I survived. I crashed in a bombed out Ocean Air Force base, then got arrested for breaking wartime aviation laws or some crap. The world went from being at peace to being at war, all in the blink of an eye.
Thank you.
was tried, found guilty, and stuffed into a cargo ship. For company, I had some court-martialed soldiers. And remember those mothballed planes I told you about before? They were loaded on the ship, too. We headed down south for several days, and then swung east. That's how I got here. I was thousands of kilometers from Arusia, on the opposite side of the Usian continent. For a port, it was dull as hell. It had three rusty patrol boats. And the base? The fences were topped with razor wire, the tower had a searchlight and machine guns, and a truck with a gun turret was parked in front of the gate. Its gun was aimed at the yard. This was a prison. This place looked like a full-on base, but half the tanker trucks were just big balloons, and the runways weren't even paved, just painted on the dirt. The whole place was just one big fat lie. The only reason I was here is because they knew I'd restored a supersonic plane. They wanted me to make something out of the mothballed planes they brought, that they could park on the fake runway. Can you believe that shit? So, I tried to escape. They found out and set the dogs on me.
Okay, so if you've never played an Ace Combat game, it's in what's called Strange Real. So OCN is supposed to be the United States, Yuktobani is supposed to be Russia, Balkans are Germany. I do not know who is Arusia, which is weird.
Right after the declaration was made, surprise,
I'd make a strange guess and say Britain because of how the map's set up, but yeah, we're skipping. Like I said, we were. Destroy the enemy ground facilities. Great ground mission. Alright, so a lot of radar vehicles. Alright, let's check out the archive tree. Points where to pay. Oh, so they really want me to do multiplayer. Okay. Holy Christ. Well, yeah, we gotta buy that. So they really just want me to keep me on the F-16. That is totally fine. I have no problem with it because the F-16 is awesome. Switch to you.
Mage Squadron, sortie, ASAP.
I do not like air-to-ground missions. But You have to have them.
Rails, but they're still military vehicles and anti-air weaponry. Destroy the target. But HQ has made it clear that no harm should come to civilians and no damage is to be done to public facilities.
But, any aircraft shot down could land in civilian territory.
No point arguing. That's how war is these days.
Do you have visual on the now. Anti-air radar vehicles? They should be close.
Yep.
Mage 2, locked. Mage 2, bombs away.
Target has been destroyed.
Intercept! Fire the AA! Get the radar vehicle out of there!
It's popping off now, Trigger. War has officially begun.
Come on, come on.
They've got their anti-air guns aimed right at us.
Target destroyed. Five to go.
Get the fighters out there. Protect the radar vehicle.
Crap.
We're using the containers now. Those weapons are meant for tactical flexibility. Shit. Where are the damn interceptors?
Well, I got three bombs left. That's not a good start.
Targeting range of guns.
In real life, I would have been dead because I hit the wires, but, you know.
Continue to engage at your discretion.
I'm not going to complain that much.
Enemy interceptors inbound. Prepare to engage in 30 seconds.
Shit.
Here they come. Take them down. Okay, recruits. Pay attention to who's on what side. The newest IFF is connected to our entire force via satellite. It's reliable, so trust your radars.
How the hell is the enemy able to hit it so accurately? It's camouflaged.
Alright. We're gonna keep these three bombs just to be safe.
Mage 2, APC destroyed. Two targets remaining.
Oh no. Oh no, where's it coming from? No, right in front of me. Oh, this got fun. Shot. Wow, that was a bad move. I do not care about the mix right now. Okay, now I care about the mix. I don't think that's gonna hit. Oh, wait. Nope. Never mind.
The clouds don't just affect your field of vision. They also mess with your HUD and radar. The seekers can sometimes lose their lock-on to their targets, too.
In gun range.
Column 4, Fox 2.
Yeah, well, it's not affecting me. Sorry, my voice is a little sore right now.
Enemy will crash in a residential area.
Just worry about staying alive for now.
work.
Hold the enemy aircraft away from the main.
Radar vehicle's destroyed, but the interceptor shows no sign
of
retreating.
I'm not gonna hit that.
Take it out. Continue with the mission. Crush as many as you can.
Enemy transport detected.
Oh, Christ. Now this got a little crazy. God, of course he's below me. Kinda wanna take out the base, but whatever. Oh, don't hit me, don't hit me. Yeah, that's why I'm doing it.
Attack missed.
All right. Let's do another pass on the airfield.
They took a bite out of me. Breaking. Missile fire. Evading. God damn it. I'm further from that radar unit.
Mage 2. Vehicle destroyed.
I'm iced up.
Targeting gun range.
Oh, you are so dead. What the fuck? Motherfucker just exploded. Well, they've all exploded, but that was like an EMP bomb. Oh shit, UAVs. Okay.
Multiple bogeys on radar. They're close.
Wait, they're being launched.
You're clear to engage. They're probably hostile.
Judging by the way they look and move, they gotta be drones.
Well spotted, clown. No doubt about it, we're dealing with UAVs. But that doesn't change a thing. Just think of them as somewhat clever decoys. Take them all down. These drones have great agility. All aircraft. You know what high G turns are, right? Use them. HQ, this is Gollum 1. Bandits confirmed as UAVs. Repeat, bandits are drones.
Gollum 1, that doesn't matter. Destroy all enemy fighters and get out.
That's not. Oh, that did hit. I actually died myself. Is it?
I've got him in my sights.
Stall warning.
Oh, I stalled. Whoops.
Fox 2.
Enemy UAV confirmed destroyed. Hell yeah.
Gollum Squadron, you're not gonna let Mage get all the glory, are ya?
Three enemies to go.
I'm buying dinner for anyone who takes down an enemy.
There's a bar I wanna try.
You're doing good.
We're going for you. Things move pretty damn fast. It's impressive.
The aircraft is icing up. I'm getting a warning.
Get out of the clouds. The ice will melt.
Where'd he go?
One to go. Let's get through this without any casualties.
Okay.
clouds are screwing up the accuracy.
Well, duh. That's what they're supposed to do.
Nice kill, Trigger. Right. Enemy aircraft confirmed down.
The skies are clear. Nice work, everyone. Mission complete. RTB.
No casualties. We couldn't have done any better. Returning to base.
I don't know. Maybe the bandits we took down caused civilian casualties.
No point arguing. That's how war is these days.
You shoot, someone gets killed. The guys in charge take care
great
of the
way
rest.
It. Not really. Lord Almighty.
Current target.
So, to give you a quick little story of why, A, I love Ace Combat, but also, yes, another
You've
trophy,
given us
kick-ass.
Air superiority by destroying their radar.
F-16s. I'm gonna try to make sure I don't do any declassified stuff. My brother's brother-in-law is an Air Force pilot. Won't say name, won't say rank, obviously, but he's been it since he was 18. And one time I got to go to his Air Force base and then go to the bombing field. So the squadron was all F-16s and they did bombing runs with the actual weapons I just used. And we were in the watchtower and it was A, really fun to watch, but B, tower requested a flyby and having four F-16s fly by that tower maybe 200 feet above us. Now, again, 200 feet is huge, but when you're in a watchtower and you're seeing planes fly above you, they look pretty damn close. Was probably the most amazing thing I've ever seen in my young life. And that was when I was like 12 at the time. I've always wanted to fly, but A, I'm a blind bat. Not as blind as Corey, though. So that's a good thing. But B, I'm blind. I don't have good vision. That's a little backstory. I'm going to try to get better with commentary, but sometimes I get a little in tunnel vision with this game. Alright. This will be the end of that episode. That episode, my god. It's fucking 1 o'clock in the morning. You can tell I'm starting to get tired. I'm screwing up my sentences. This will be the end of this episode. I will see you all in the next one. Goodbye, everyone.